this video, we'll be covering AMCA probabilities problems. The first problem is, a bag contains 5 red marbles, 3 blue marbles, and 2 green marbles. If one marble is chosen at random, what is the probability of selecting a red marble? So, there are 5 red marbles, 3 blue marbles, and 2 green marbles. And this totals to 10 marbles in all. So, we have 10 total marbles, and out of those 10 total marbles, 5 of them are red. So, when we take a marble out of this bag, we have a 5/10th chance of getting a red marble, or a 1/2 chance. So, if you got 1/2, you were correct. This is the answer. Let's move on to the next problem. A fair coin is flipped 3 times. What is the probability of getting at least one head? So, when we flip a coin once, the probability of getting a head is 1/2. Now, let's see the probability of getting all tails when we do 3 times. This is the counter probability of getting at least one head. So that would be 1/2 to the power of 3, which would equal 1/8. Now, if we subtract 1/8 from 1, we would get 7/8. So, we have a 7/8 chance of getting at least one head when flipping a coin 3 times. Now, let's move on to the last problem in the easy section. A box contains 4 red balls and 6 blue balls. 2 balls are drawn at random without replacement. What is the probability that both balls are red? So, let's go over the solution. For the first time that the ball is drawn, we have a 4/10 chance of picking a red ball, because there are 4 red balls out of 10 total balls. Now, in the second time, we only have 3 red balls left and 9 total balls left, because we took out 1 red ball. So 3/9 is our second chance of getting a red ball again. So if we multiply these probabilities, we would get 12/90, which could be simplified to 4/30, and finally be simplified to 2/15. If you got 2/15, you are correct. Now we're in the medium section of problems. These problems may be a little bit harder, so take your time to answer them. A standard deck of cards is shuffled and 1 card is drawn at random. What is the probability of selecting a diamond or a heart? Okay, let's go over the solution. Take your time and pause this video if you need to. So, a standard deck of cards has 52 cards. And we have diamonds, hearts, spades, and clubs. So there would be 13 diamonds and 13 hearts. Because 13 times 4 is 52. So, if we add the 13 and 13, we'd get 26 cards out of 52 cards that qualify for being a diamond or a heart. Simplifying this, we would get 1/2. Let's move on to the next problem. In a school, 60% of the students play soccer, 40% play basketball, and 20% play both. If a student is chosen at random, what is the probability that they play at least one of these sports? So, we have 60% playing soccer, and then 40% playing basketball, so we can add these, but then we need to subtract the 20% that play both because we're overcounting them. So we can subtract it from either side. I'll just subtract it from 40. So 60 plus 40 minus 20, which would be 60 plus 20, which is 80. So 80% of the people in the school play at least one of these sports. A bag contains 8 identical red balls and 4 identical blue balls. 3 balls are drawn at random without replacement. What is the probability of drawing exactly 2 red balls? Okay, so when we draw the first ball, we have an 8 out of 12 chance of getting a red ball. Now the second time, we'll have a 7 out of 11 chance. Because we took one red ball, and there are 11 balls left in total. Now, the third time, we do not want a red ball because we want to draw exactly 2 red balls. So, you have to find the probability of not getting a red ball. So there are 4 blue balls left and 6 red balls left. So there are 4 out of 10 chances that we'll get a blue ball, which is not a red ball. So we have to multiply by 4 out of 10. Okay. So now, if we multiply all of these fractions, we'd get, so for the numerator, 8 times 4 is 32, 32 times 7 is 224, and 12 times 11 is 132, 132 times 10 is easy, we just have to add a 0, and it is 1,320. So, 224 over 1,320. You could simplify this, but I'm not going to in this video. Now let's move on to the next problem. Okay, these are the difficult problems, so take your time with these. A woman asked 3 men separately which dress they like the best out of 5 she tries on for them. They all picked the same dress as their favorite. She is concerned that they didn't really look at the dresses but just chose randomly. What is the probability that they would all pick the same dress if they were simply making random guesses? I will go over the solution in some time. Meanwhile, take your time to answer this. So, we've noted that there are three men, so we have to have three slots to multiply. And you would think that would be 1/5 times 1/5 times 1/5 because there are five guesses. But, let's say the five guesses are numbered 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. We don't know if all the men are going to pick 1, or if all the men are going to pick 4, all the men are going to pick 3, So if we're saying 1/5 times 1/5 times 1/5, we're assuming that we already know that they're going to pick one choice. But it could be any choice. So the first guy really has any choice for what dress he wants. So he has five choices out of five dresses. So the fraction would be 5 out of 5. Now, the second man has to choose whatever the first guy chose, be it 1, 2, 3, 4, or 5, because this guy got any choice he wants because he's the first guy. He can't be wrong. So this guy will get 1/5 because he only has one choice out of five. And finally, the third guy will also be 1/5 because he has to choose the same dress as the first guy and the second guy. So, now if we multiply this, we'd first set 5 out of 5 to 1. And then 1/5 times 1/5 is 1/25. Times 1, it's still 1/25. 1/25 is our answer. Congratulations if you got that right. Now, let's move on to the next problem. A bag has 20 female student numbers and 25 male student numbers in it. Two student numbers are to be randomly selected without replacement. What is the probability that both numbers will be for members of the same gender? Now, so, since the bag has 20 female student numbers and 25 male student numbers, we're seeing the probability of two numbers of the same gender. But like the other problem, we don't know if the numbers could be for men or women. So because if the numbers were for men, we'd have to calculate another probability. And if they were for women, we'd have to calculate probably for them. So what we're going to have to do is we're going to have to add these two probabilities. By the way, don't mind my writing here. It's just kind of hard to write with a cursor. Okay, now let's get to solving this. So for female, we have 20 out of 45 chances to get a first female number. And then times 19 out of 44 chances to get the second female number. So, and then we have to add the male probability. So, 25 out of 45 chance to get the first male number. And 24 out of 44 chance to get the second male number. So, now we just have to add these probabilities. If I put this entire fraction into a calculator, I'd get 49 over 99, or 0.49 0.495, which is 49.5% chance that we get two numbers of the same gender. Now, 49.99 and 49.5% are both the answer. Let's move on to the next problem. A fair six-sided die is rolled twice. What is the probability that the sum of the two numbers rolled is greater than 9? Take your time to solve this, and then I will release the answer. Okay, so we're rolling a six-sided die two times, which means that we do 6 times 6, which is 36. So we have 36 total possibilities and outcomes when we're rolling this die twice. So we need to find how many out of those 36 are equal to a number greater than 9. So, let's list all the combinations possible. 4 and 6. 6 and 4. And then we can do 5 and 6. And 6 and 5. And then finally, we can do 5 and 5 and 6 and 6. So you see, there are 6 total possibilities that are greater than 9. So we can simplify 6 out of 36 to 1/6. So, if you got this correct, congratulations. Now let's move on to a challenge. I've got a challenge for you that I won't release the answer in this video. What is the probability of guessing a 4-digit PIN? Put your answer in the comments, because the first 4 people to guess the answer correctly get a shout out in my next video. That'll be all. Goodbye. Thanks for watching this video. I hope you found it informative. Let me know what you thought of it in the comment section below. Be sure to subscribe to my channel and click on the bell icon so you never miss on a video. Have a wonderful time!